Hello and welcome to Cal Poly iPad Support. This video is here to show you how to set up your Zimbra Calendar on your iPad. This is going to be very similar to setting up your Cal Poly email on your iPad if you have only one calendar. If you have many shared calendars, however, and don't want them to be loaded onto your iPad, you need to complete the following steps. On your computer, log into your Cal Poly portal to access your Zimbra email and calendars. Once in Zimbra, click the Preferences tab. In the panel on the left side of the screen, click Calendar. Now scroll to the bottom of the page to find the Apple iCal section, and check the Enable Delegation for Apple iCal Cal DAV Client. Like I said before, this is to prevent any shared calendars from being loaded to your iPad, and is completely optional. So now we can actually go to the iPad side of this. Starting at the home screen, select Settings. On the left side of the screen, select Mail, Contacts, Calendars, and then Add Account. Tap Other, and then Add Cal DAV Account. Next to Server, you need to enter connect.calpoly.edu. Username and password will be the same as your Cal Poly portal username and password. The description can be named whatever you want. Once finished, tap the Next button. Your account will be verified and you should have access to your Cal Poly Zimbra calendar through your iOS calendar application. Now we can go over how to create an event on your iPad calendar. Look for the plus sign in the top right corner of the screen. Then tap on that sign to open the Add Event menu. Here you can manage anything you like about the event. Title, location, beginning and end, very basic stuff. If you have an event that you know will be recurring, say a weekly meeting for example, you can set the repeat option to every week. You can also set alerts so that you will be reminded of the event anywhere between 5 minutes and a week before the event. You can also set a second alarm if you know that you're the type of person that will need it. When you are finished, tap Done. Now you can see the events and that they are every Sunday because we selected every week. Don't forget that you can edit the event at any time. Just tap Edit, which is also where you would go if you wanted to delete the event. You can also easily set an event using Siri, your iPad's virtual assistant. To access Siri, simply hold down the Home button. Now you can have her set your event. For example, saying, "Siri, schedule an appointment tomorrow with Johnson at 9 a.m. Siri will then confirm that she heard you right, and if she did, you can tap Confirm. And just like that, it is in your calendar. Just be sure to enunciate clearly and loudly, and Siri should get what you're saying. You can also add more details, for example by saying, "Add a repeating event titled Faculty Meeting at 10 a.m. every Thursday." Be warned though, the longer you make your request, the more likely it is that Siri may mishear you, so be sure to be as specific as possible. You can always go to the calendar app yourself and edit it. So that's it for this video on iPad calendars. If you have any more questions about how to use your iPad, don't hesitate to visit ipadsupport.calpoly.edu.